Right, welcome. Subscribe to our channel. You feel it's good. Yeah. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and thank you for watching. My topic today is adding a rule. When you add a rule, you just go to your people and then you add a rule. See? I'm here in the rule here and I want to add a guest or just a blog or a blogger. I add here a rule. So this will be in our database. This one we're gonna change this one once we add this one. So this is the rule name. So we put here blogger. And then, or just a block, so we could save the space and permission. I think we have a name here, block, permission code, so we make sure there's no duplicate or redundancy. It's the name input. I put their blogger, and I'll be adding the permission on here. Just click the permission. And then, by the way, this is the, forget to click here. This is the, our access that we have. The permission we have the administrator, content guy, podcast talk, and then we just add the blogger. Okay, click here the permission. So this one I'm using the Drupal 8. This is the permission of our blogger. This one. So this will be permission that we need to acquire. So it's been customized here. Okay, we just add check that one. And then edit comments. All right, then edit the comments. And then we have here the content. Use context link. And then it's the user interface there. Comments. And then what else do you have to get? Media here, with any images, create the media here. This is the blogger, right? The data guest. So there we go. Create new content for the blogger. And then what else? You can create the content and article, delete all content and edit all content. So find the article here, the article. You can find the article here, but you can also delete. Edit in the content, I will not allow that one. Edit all, there we go. Edit all content, you can edit. Edit all content. And what else do we have here? Yeah. I think that is, that's the access we need, and we need also the URL here we can add for the search engine. This is very useful for them. And I'll use it to use the, use a panel dashboard would be good for you. And access in editing, access in place editing. Okay, let me go there and then search. I don't think you need to search a lot. Just type, you just add the entry. Submission. And then here is you can change. Change own username. Yeah, you change your own username there and view user information. Alright, that's if you can need. So again, we review, we just access the check mark that we put, you can edit the check mark we put there. And then you can also, alright, that's the article you want to write. And then delete all, just delete all content. Use the dashboard panel and the URL. You could put it. The team member did not use it for a fast offer. This is determined or not user or not invite. The path has been changed. Use the toolbar. Use the toolbar also that you can use it. Okay, maybe we have done it all. Use the toolbar. Statistic view, conflict hits, check, access, create. So now I'm just reviewing here, so we could know. This is the access the content overview page. Okay, that's it for the blogger, and then we save the permission. Alright, so we just create the permission that we need, and then next time you know is to, yeah, we need to check, we need to log in to the other, we just wait for a while. Alright, here we gonna be, having the permission, the blogger, and we just create. And then we just check this one, log. And contact form. I'll just put the blogger here with the one to put the one. So we just create now. That's been created right now. So we just, you have to log in here for a while. So we just access the access we just created. So we just type here the title and things you need to done for as a guest right there. So that's it. Everything is working well now, and you have the blogger access for it. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and see you soon.